a lot of our patients with heart failure aren't getting good palliative care. So we can look at it from the physician point of view. A lot of the cases of advanced heart failure are managed by cardiologists or by heart failure specialists. And often they tend to continue treatment more aggressively and try to prepare the patient for transplant if possible, until the patient can no longer cope or clinical status is declining, and then they get palliative care. Whereas our hypothesis was, let's start early, even if the patient might be eligible for transplant in the future, let's control their symptoms, let's make them feel better, and let's try to improve their quality of life. Sarah Goodlin published a very good graph that shows the patient trajectory in heart failure. And very briefly, once they have heart failure, they tend to not do as well, but medication improves them to a point where they can often plateau, and then as they near the end of their life, they often have exacerbations and improvements. But there comes a point when they can no longer improve with admission to hospital and aggressive therapy. And that is the time where they definitely need palliative care. But what we're proposing, and what has been already demonstrated by other groups, is that heart failure palliative care should be started earlier, so that they know the team, that they have a plan for what to do if the patient has dyspnea or exacerbations, or if they don't want to go through the same treatment that they've tried before in order to get them back to that plateau. And so I think it's really a case of communicating effectively with the patient and explaining to them what the future holds, what to anticipate, and also what treatments are available. What I can talk about a little bit is the pilot project that we started at St. Paul's in January 2011. And we had the opportunity of starting the clinic within the heart failure program. And essentially, patients that are not eligible for transplant, patients that have NYHA class 3 or 4, so very advanced heart failure, and that have severe symptoms, would be seen by our clinic, and our goal would be to try to improve their symptoms and keep them at home. And what we found in our experience for the first 25 patients is that there were very few admissions subsequent to that to the hospital for acute decompensated heart failure. And for a lot of the patients, their ESAS scores, or their scores of symptom burden, were improving. So to us, that meant that maybe we should do more research in this and try to expand the clinic. When the patient comes to see us, we review their clinical status, we carefully review their heart failure notes, and we come up with a pathway in which we can guide the patient to make decisions based on what they would like if things get worse, how to communicate in terms of ICD deactivation, what to do if they can't manage at home, what to do if they have shortness of breath or pain, who should we be in contact with if they can't make decisions for themselves, where would they like to be, at a hospice or home or hospital if things got worse. So we have a list of questions that we ask the patient, and we get to know them, and over a few visits, over a few months, we establish rapport with them, and we're able to recommend medications and a clinical pathway that best suits them. Every patient has a nurse practitioner assigned to the patient. Every patient has a family doctor in the community. All of these patients are outpatients, and essentially it's just adding me and some of the principles of palliative care to the program. And so from the hospital point of view, I don't think it was much more of an expense than just the organization of the clinic.